Hello, and thank you for joining us online today for our virtual Veterans Day celebration. And if you served, thank you for your service. Whether you served in the Coast Guard, the Air Force, the Army, the Navy, or the Marine Corps, we are grateful for your service to our country. Although we can't meet in person this year, veterans and their families are too important to allow this pandemic to keep us from saying thank you. Over the next few minutes, you'll hear the bands and the choirs, you'll hear some essays written by students, and you'll get to see a short video presentation. It is our hope that you feel blessed and appreciated by the hard work of our staff and students. Thank you to the staff at CMS who have worked to make this happen. Thank you to the students who have contributed their efforts. Thank you to everyone in attendance, but mostly and most importantly, thank you to our veterans for your courage and your sacrifices.
Veterans Day originated as Armistice Day on November 11, 1919, commemorating the first anniversary of the end of World War I. Congress passed a resolution in 1926 for an annual observance, and November 11th became a national holiday beginning in 1938. Unlike Memorial Day, Veterans Day pays tribute to all American veterans, living or dead, but especially gives thanks to living veterans who served their country honorably during war or peacetime. Who are veterans? They are those who answered the call of their country in times of great peace or great conflict. They have stepped forward, signed up, and sworn oath to defend their nation. Today we honor them for their service to God and our country.
A word has the power to change your life. Think about that for a moment, because it is literally an earth-moving statement to change your life. For more than a decade, technology has brought words into our lives more than ever before. No longer are words just what we hear, write, or read. They have become what we create and how we interact with the world around us. Words have a dramatic impact on what we know, how we interact with people, and the decisions we ultimately make. Words can influence us, inspire us, or just as easily bring us to tears. With that being said, we will be using the power of the words of a few middle school students to honor our veterans with the Patriot's Pen Essay Contest, which encourages young minds to examine America's history along with their own experiences in modern American society. This year's theme is, What is Patriotism to Me?
Formed on October 13, 1775, the birth of the United States Navy slightly predates the beginning of the United States. As such, for its first few years in existence, the fleet was a part of the Continental Army and was devoted to disrupting shipments that came to the country from Great Britain. The initial fleet was mostly made up of commercial sailors in their own ships. In traditional American fashion, from small beginnings rose an important U.S. institution. The U.S. Navy has now been involved in over 10 major wars, defended the country against pirates, and played an important role in relief efforts worldwide. Thank you to our sailors for your service.
I'm Zoe Pulaski, and I'm reading to you my essay on what patriotism is to me. In the past, there have been many great wars with other countries in the world. One of the most important for our country was the war against Britain. It's how we gained our freedom and rights today, and how we built our future in America. Patriotism to me is like getting a new game. You get it and you never really stop loving it. Patriotism means to me that we fought the war with Britain to gain this freedom. The Great War with Britain lasted from April 19, 1775 to September 3, 1783. On September 17, 1787, the Constitution was first signed, leading to December 7th when five other states signed the Constitution. The Constitution was created to have enough power as a government, but not as enough that the fundamental rights would be at risk. The Constitution was made mainly for the freedom of America, free from the reign of Britain. Slavery was a big part of the trip to freedom. Not all African Americans began with freedom. Slavery mostly took place in the southern states. African Americans were taken from their homes and forced to become slaves in the United States. This was an act of taking away their rights. Slavery, but not racism, ended on January 31st, 1865. The Revolutionary War was what ended Britain's reign over the current 13 states. It gave the 13 states part of their freedom. They, of course, had to sign the Constitution, along with other states. The war was won by the Americans that later had freedom from Britain. Over 20% of the colonists were still loyal to Britain as the war happened. They helped work with Britain to keep their rule over the states. Patriotism is an important part of America, considering everything we went through for freedom for all. Now, everyone is free and has equal rights. Many people are patriotic and very supportive of America, and maybe even home countries they came from or relatives came from. To this day, America is a very patriotic country many Americans live in and are happy in. Overall, America is a very patriotic country that many people happy live in. I hope you enjoyed listening to my essay about patriotism, and I hope that you're very patriotic too.
On June 14, 1775, the Second Continental Congress formed the Continental Army as a means for the 13 unified American colonies to fight the forces of Britain. George Washington was unanimously elected Commander-in-Chief of the fleeing army, and he would lead the colonies to victory and independence. Over time, that army has grown into one of history's most fearsome fighting forces.
Today, the army is made up of more than 700,000 soldiers, including active duty and Army Reserve personnel. They are doctors, lawyers, and engineers. They are electricians, computer programmers, and helicopter pilots. They are police officers, logistics experts, and civil affairs representatives. The Army's constant need for a diverse range of individual soldiers, each with his or her own experiences, is what sets it apart from other military branches. Thank you to our soldiers for your bravery and sacrifices.
First to fight for the right and to build the nation's might, and the army goes rolling along. Proud of all we have done, fighting till the battle's won, and the army goes rolling along. For it's high, high, hey, the army's on its way. Count off the kingdoms, good and strong.
What is patriotism to me? To me, patriotism is like a passion. There are things and ideas that we love that are our passions. We have this enthusiasm for these passions because of the traits that make up who we are. Patriotism makes up what we stand for. We stand for the freedom our country provides us. We follow what the Constitution says and we protect it. We will always love our country, so we pledge to remain loyal to it. We do what we can to help it run. Whether an individual runs some nationwide company or a small-town shop, we take part in helping our country thrive. Our soldiers join the military because they love this country. Benjamin Franklin once stated, "A right heart exceeds all." The best soldiers in our countries aren't the strongest ones, but ones who care the most. the ones who will fight their heart out to save their country. It is these men who are the greatest heroes to our country, the most passionate ones. They will stay to fight for our rights no matter what the conditions or consequences may be. Because of these people, United States citizens can go to sleep at night feeling safe, feeling protected, feeling at home. And when they wake up in the morning, they are ready to go to work and do their part to serve their country. All the mothers, fathers, and teachers devoting their time to helping children develop who they are the ones shaping the next generation. This is important because the values and ideas they teach these children today will determine how our country will be run down the line. They too are people who are passionate about the future and are willing to work to make sure our country stays the same, safe, humble country it is. Being kind and generous to others is a great deed. When we reach out and help our neighbors, we create a more positive, unified environment. Benjamin Franklin once said, "When you're good to others, you're best to yourself." Even children have an important job in determining our country's future. It is their job to learn and find their passions that will one day change the world. Throughout a lifetime, we have many opportunities to grow as citizens and remain loyal to our country. That is what patriotism is all about, staying loyal to your passion for this country.
On November 10th, 1775, the Second Continental Congress, meeting in Philadelphia, passed a resolution saying that 2 battalions of Marines be raised for service as landing forces with the fleet. This resolution established the Continental Marines and marked the birth date of the United States Marine Corps. Serving on land and at sea, these first Marines distinguished themselves in a number of important operations, including their first ambitious raid into the Bahamas in March 1776 under the command of Major Samuel Nicholas. The first commissioned officer in the Continental Marines, Nicholas remained the senior Marine officer throughout the American Revolution and is considered to be the first Marine commandant. Today, there are more than 200,000 active duty and reserve Marines, organized into 3 divisions, stationed at Camp Lejeune, Camp Pendleton, and Okinawa, Japan. Each division has 1 or more expeditionary units ready to launch major operations anywhere on short notice. Marines' expeditionary units are self-sufficient with their own tanks, artillery, and air forces. The motto of the service is Semper Fidelis, meaning always faithful in Latin.
Patriotism. J. Horace McFarland once said, "It is the love of country that has lighted and that keeps glowing the holy fire of patriotism." This love of country is apparent every day, shown in ways such as a flag waving on a pole, the Pledge of Allegiance being promised in a school, and larger methods, like enlisting in the military. Patriotism to me is the love shown in the symbols, words, and actions of the people that all help our country's flame grow brighter. Part of patriotism is connection, given by symbols. How many times have you looked at a flag and felt a surge of pride for your country? How many immigrants have looked upon Lady Liberty and felt hope for the new country and family they would have? Symbols giving us connection is a strong part of patriotism, as it's the feeling of belonging with America. With connection, we begin to stack the logs for our patriotic fire. Words are ways to share the love of America, such as the Pledge of Allegiance. It helps spread awareness about our country from a young age. Patriotic love is even shown in America's birth. 85 essays were written to support the new Constitution. This Constitution is another prime example of this love. Words are gasoline that fuels us in the flame. Actions define us louder than words and are the final execution of patriotism. The 17.4 million veterans and 1.3 million current armed forces are a key example. They have fought in wars for a chance at peace, everyday citizens having been completed important actions. The past election, 250,056,000 people showed up to vote. Sometimes actions are small, like singing the national anthem at a sports game. These citizens are doing these things because of their love for the United States. Actions are the final spark setting the fire ablaze. Patriotism to me is the love of the United States that is apparent in almost all things. Connection and symbols help lay tinder, words provide fuel, and actions set a spark of love that burns the fire of patriotism. Whether it be the next time you sing the national anthem, promise the Pledge of Allegiance while facing a flag, or vote in the upcoming election, look around. View how love for a country is shown in everyday life, and add your spark to the shining fire of America.
On August 1, 1907, the U.S. Army Signal Corps established a small aeronautical division to take control of all matters pertaining to military ballooning, air machinery, and all kindred subjects. The division grew from its first official airplane purchase from the Wright brothers in 1908 to the creation of the official branch in 1947.
Today, the Air Force continues its tradition of innovation, constantly striving to produce ever more sophisticated platforms in both air and space to protect the nation from those who would seek to do us harm. Its pilots fly jet fighters that have not lost an air-to-air engagement in over 40 years, while its bombers can penetrate anywhere in the world protected by stealth technology. Thank you to the men and women of the United States Air Force for your courage and for your sacrifice.
Off we go into the wild blue yonder, climbing high into the sun. Here they come, zooming to meet our thunder. Attaboys, here they come.
Here they come!
Down we dive, spouting our flames from under. Off we go, one hell of a roar. We live in fear.
The warriors. Our flag does not fly because the wind moves it. It flies with the last breath of each soldier who died protecting it. The author of that quote is unknown, but they are absolutely right. The most patriotic thing you can do for your country is to fight to protect it. If you're unable to do that, celebrate those who do fight. Our country was founded on the fact that we did not have the freedoms that should be granted to each individual on this earth. Those who believe in this fought for those beliefs against Great Britain. They were considered patriots. These were the most patriotic people in our history, and patriot is right in their name. Because they were brave enough to fight for us, Americans can now enjoy the rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Now, people are fighting for us to continue having those freedoms and for others to be granted those rights. Some cannot fight for our country, so they should celebrate those who do. Thank those in our military and talk to them about their experiences, if they are willing to talk. If you work for something like an insurance agency, maybe try talking to the manager to see if they could give veterans a discount. They fight for freedom for humanity, and they deserve our gratitude. The fighters of freedom are our saviors, and there is no nobler job. If they stop fighting, there would be no rights for anyone. We would be at the mercy of our rulers, for if we could say what we want, write what we want, practice what religion we want, and more. Our entire country relies on those men and women to fight for our humanity. They are stronger patriots than any one of us.
The Coast Guard's official history began on August 4th, 1790, when the first Congress authorized the construction of 10 vessels to enforce federal tariff and trade laws and to prevent smuggling. The service received its present name in 1915 under an act of Congress that merged the Revenue Cutter Service with the Life-Saving Service, thereby providing the nation with a single maritime service dedicated to saving life at sea and enforcing the nation's maritime laws. The Coast Guard began to maintain the country's aids to maritime navigation and opening the nation's lighthouses when President Franklin Roosevelt ordered the transfer of the lighthouse service to the Coast Guard in 1939. Since 2003, the Coast Guard has operated as a part of the Department of Homeland Security, serving as the nation's frontline agency for enforcing the nation's laws at sea, protecting the marine environment and the nation's vast coastline and ports, and saving life.
Death. We are soldiers, we are soldiers. Whoa. us, you'll just have to face us.
In July 1862, during the Civil War, General Daniel Butterfield created what recognized as an important piece of music in America. He was dissatisfied with the standard call used to indicate lights out in the army. He wanted something more melodious, so he took it upon himself to rework their current call. These simple 24 notes rapidly spread through the army and even caught on with other Confederates. It was first played at the funeral of a Union soldier killed in action. It was called Taps by soldiers, but was officially known as Extinguished Lights until 1891, when it became formally known as Taps, which we recognize today. The sounding of Taps is heard on all military installations at the retirement of our flag at sunset. It also symbolizes the end of a soldier's day and lights out. These 24 notes are also sounded at graveside to honor a veteran and tell them their duty is done and they may rest in peace. At the sounding of Taps, it is traditional that all active duty personnel and veterans that are physically able to stand and salute, and that everyone else place their right hand over their heart.
The song "Your Grand Old Flag" is written by George M. Cohen for his 1906 stage musical, George Washington Jr. The song was introduced to the public in the play's first act on opening night, February 6, 1906, in New York's Herald Square Theater. "Your Grand Old Flag" quickly became the first song from the musical to sell over a million copies of sheet music. Now presenting Clark 7th grade choir singing Greg Gilpin's version for you.
Pure delight, we're as proud as can be. Joining us today in celebrating our veterans. We are incredibly grateful for your service to our country. Thank you to everyone that helped put this presentation together. Please be sure to like and subscribe the Clark Music YouTube channel for future performances coming in December. Thank you again, and good night, everyone.